we hired the purse seiners to capture the aggregations or portions of the aggregations. And then we set up these special sampling tables, which Joel Bickford designed, so that we could have the fish kept in the purse seine, and they would get dip netted out and put into these special tables with running water so that we could work them up without having to kill them. And what we would do is we would get a genetic sample, a sample of reproductive state and the size of the fish, and we could sample up to 1,000 fish in a day, and all these fish are being released alive. So typically these types of studies, the fish gets sacrificed to get this type of data to understand what's going on, and this was just a great opportunity that the type of data we needed, we didn't have to sacrifice them. And some of the things you learn. So one of the most amazing things I've seen in these 3 years of this study is seeing the released fish swim around and swim up and down on the outside of the net, waiting for their schoolmates to be released. So there's just really strong schooling instinct and these behaviors that you just would never know if you didn't get to see them or study them in their natural environment.